Thanks for coming back. In today's video, we're going to be at my friend's house that passed away a couple of years ago this month. That I just can't hardly believe it. But I have sold 3 engines and some tires for him today. Well, for his widow. And we're going to take them out, get them loaded. Before we get into the video, I want to show you this. I'd like to thank Harbor Freight. Or Jacob and I would like to thank Harbor Freight for the opportunity for partnering with us and showing this air compressor. It's a fortress. As you can see in this video, we use it and we use it a lot, and it absolutely does the job. Easy start. As you know, I talk about Harbor Freight in the videos a lot. I buy most of my tools from them. Simply because they fit my budget. Jacob and I are really excited to get this. It has been raining so much that we really hadn't had the opportunity to put it to work. And when we do find a pretty day, we're on a project that we actually didn't need it. But today, we're going to unbox this thing. We're going to show you what Harbor Freight has sent us. A lid on top of it, or a hood. I'm going to call it a hood, like an engine hood. The thing is heavy. I know that. It's not light duty at all. This Fortress 30-gallon truck bed compressor also has 175 max PSI, has 24 SCFM at 90 PSI, has 96 dBA. Hank helped me to get it mounted. The only way I know how to promote something is just get out there and use it. Let's just get started on this video and we'll show you how this Fortress air compressor does as we put it to work. Let me see if I can pull start it. Yes, I got to do this right here.
Look at that.
You normally like being petted by me. What's wrong?
Look at on the excavators. Look at this one. Oh, he just crossed the chain around. Hook that on his excavator and then hook that big hook right in here. That'll handle it perfect. Yeah, just hook that on his excavator or somewhere over there. We'll set that right on the back. We can twist it whichever way we want it. Blade, you can set it on the back.
You doing right?
Right around up there, Wally.
Huh?
Up there, right there around that side. Either way, he can go up pretty high.
But yeah.
It's a long time.
Come on forward if you can.
Hook back into it?
Yeah.
All right.
Well, a little ass. You'll have to come out this way a little bit.
Hey, come on in, son, if you can.
They're getting it.
Alright.
Far ahead.
Did you make it?
thing is still get backwards out there.
Yeah, my blade's still hooked to the cylinder pins.
Yeah, take it off on the trailer that way, you know.
Now the fun part is getting that pin out.
I don't think
it'll
hang for one hook in this
corner. What about hook one hook right here and one hook over on the motor ground on the other side?
All right. Yeah, pick up on that. All right, ease up on it.
There you go. All right, pick it up there.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Perfect.
There you go.
Hey, wait. There you go. I don't think it will. Just don't let it hit your foot.
Still another
side okay. Loose. Okay. All look right.
At there. Pick it on up a little bit.
Don't let it get you now. All right, what about your side? Your side good?
Hey, swing this thing over out of the way of the damn blade or something.
You peed on me, Ronnie.
Probably good.
All right, right about there. You want to go up? Watch out now.
Here we go.
Come on.
Take
down
it to the house.
That'd be fine.
We'll figure it out on the trailer. Set that end down first.
Let's go help him be getting those tires and all situated. We're gonna try our new AirCat out today. It's an 1870P. Not the half inch, that's the half inch hook to 3/8 to. Here's what's neat right here. You don't have to have a battery. We haven't got it like we want it yet. Got to pull this thing up to start it. I did figure that out. Whew. Got some torque, ain't it? Oh, yeah. Is that what it's doing?
Yeah.
Now watch the tire. If you see it coming back, just leave it.
I mean, it's already out.
Okay, just bring it on out then.
I mean, but it could.
You see, it's on the lip.
Just push on it. Don't let it get crushed.
Well,
taking this engine out?
I just got to lift it up and get the tires off.
Can you see right there? Yeah.
I'm hoping to lift it up in time to just shake off.
Are you trying to flip it?
Is it loose? I hope. Make sure it's loose. I don't. All right, watch out. Is all the lugs out of it? All right, pick up on it, Jimmy. Oh!
It's loose, I can feel
a budget.
That tire's stuck to the ground.
Yes, it is. Hey, see if you can go back with it. Watch out. There you go. Now you got it free.
All
right,
now.
Hey, yeah, Jacob, get on. Hey, let him pick up on it. Come on up, Jimmy. All right, lay it down. Oh, don't get in on the kill zone.
Just hey. Stuck on the end.
Yeah, I think you got it now. Come on. Dang. All right.
What we gonna do now?
Just lay it down, yeah.
I'm gonna have to let my boom out.
Okay, that's what you need to do.
Get it out under the cab.
Oh yeah. Yeah. Don't want to saw you in two.
Damn. Oh yeah.
Eric.
How about it?
You almost down. Here you go, Jacob. I kind of got an idea what I want to do. Yeah.
I mean, maybe if you put the other end on now, since it's in there.
Tell him to lift up now.
If you put the other end,
remember we got to get it out.
You gonna
ease up on it.
I don't want to say I told you so.
What do you do? Just come up there and show old man up.
Hey, I ain't trying to do that. I'm trying to help.
That make you feel good?
Maybe sometimes.
You know. Come on up on it.
I'll get you there. Might not be the best.
Jimmy, go off the end and drag it back.
you come off from the back, you can run it.
Got to come off. We're selling these for cores. You know, don't know what they're like or anything about them. But he had took this off, and it looked like they took the fan hub off of it, which is good since we got to take it off. But all we got to do now is get this off where we can hook a chain up to it and get all the wiring off of it, so when we lift it up, we're not pulling anything. We'll be through here in just a little bit. Getting the dang-um twos is the worst part about it. This off. Well, it'd help if I take it off instead of tightening it up. You hadn't seen this yet. I bought this at Harper. Yeah. All right. Well, I'm glad that one was threaded. On this side, you can get it.
Yeah.
Okay. I got the wrench.
I think it's on there.
All right. Hang on. It's definitely on there. All right. Okay. Yeah. Well, I don't know who did this, but they had to They dang sure got it. It wasn't coming off. They've had trouble with it before one time.
The breather?
Yeah, it was the breather top. It wasn't gonna come off the second time. I don't know why that one happened. There you go. Yeah. There you go. That'd do it. Okay. We make hay now. It's turning up there up top, but that ain't no problem. That one wasn't. That sucker come right off. Let's find a wrench, get up top. Alright, I've disconnected the starter wires coming from the battery. You can see they had some homemade stuff here. Now this is the control cable for the throttle. Do that. Oh, I'll get it. He can find some shorter bolts to put back in there. But I'm gonna stick them back in there so they'll be there. I know y'all didn't see that. I just snugged them up. Had the camera point straight up at the sky. If we'd had a solar eclipse, we could have seen it. Okay. Radiator's coming out with that. Yeah, probably gonna have to get this off while I'm right here. Thermostat. There.
up a little bit. Yeah, you got to grab it in. Whoa! I let it down quick!
I didn't know he had Riverside property.
Yeah.
Let me get back over here with you.
We'll see what happens. Yeah, that's a wrap around there. We'll just see.
Back up.
That boat should have got out of here or something.
All right, hold on, hold on.
Hey, where'd you rode?
Right.
You gotta press that button, but it ain't spring loaded. You still gotta pull it open all the way.
There's a frog inside of there.
That's our second frog. Go. Three motors, five tires, a blade, some cylinders. It's all headed to Indiana. Thank y'all for watching, and remember, don't be wily.